y'all are more than capable of running with the top 10 teams here. Y'all just got to believe it and go out there and show it to everybody else. All right.
Let's go.
All right, boys. Heavenly Father, you brought us here today to give us this opportunity to compete together, to run together, but for the biggest part, run for your glory. You've blessed us with an amazing season, and I could not have asked for a better group of guys to toe this line with this year. I pray that you watch over us, you bless us, you guide us, and you show us the path to our victory today. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Anyway, we worked too damn hard to get here, so let's show them what we can do.
Okay, let's go.
Carl, this is your last fucking race.
Let's get it.
Jags on me! Jags on three! 1, 2, 3! Jags!
Faith, focus, family. These are three principles that have kept the Jaguars of Augusta University grounded throughout the historic 2023 cross-country season to nationals in Joplin, Missouri. But every runner and coach knows that no season can truly begin until another one ends.
All right, ready?
Yep.
All right, what's up? We back with the Jags, and we're a little bit less lively than usual, but it's about, my watch is dead, but it's about like 3:30, and most of us stayed up till about like, I don't know, midnight last night and got up at 2:30, so we're thriving, but yeah, we're on the way back to the airport to head back to Augusta. You know, it's sad that this journey's come to an end, but it was fun, it was real. We learned a lot, and next year we're going to be dangerous. So, go Jags. You would do the same for me,
and I will do it for you. All right, let's go, AU.
So let's lock in, let's get it going. 57 guys, you know what you gotta do.
Hey man, it's snowing out here. This is crazy. I haven't seen it much.
That's
fun.
Like a drum, my heart never stops beating for you. And long after you're gone, 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 I'll love you long after you're gone, gone, gone.
Yeah, so we're at Lee right now. Yeah, I mean, we're running the 5K today. I'm excited to be here because this was kind of last minute for me to be here. I ran a good time trial last week and it earned me a spot. I'm hoping to just kind of go out there today and, you know, kick some butt. If I do well, I do well. If I don't, I don't. We're just here to have fun, have a good time, hang out with my teammates. I'm excited.
A good time. Three words that have been the summary of the past few months as track season comes to a pleasing conclusion at Lee University's Last Chance meet. Head cross country and track and field coach Jacob Bergamy is wrapping up his first year of collegiate coaching, and it's been quite a year to remember. But of course, like every collegiate season, they end as fast as they begin.
We've got a long way to go. We kind of scratched the surface, just kind of dinged it a little bit today. So, all in all, it was a good season. You know, did really well at conference as a team, and it's time to just get some much-needed rest and enjoy the summer. Get some decent miles under our belt. Not too much, but not too little. Nice B+, B- summer. November 18th. That's the day.
November 18th, a date that could arrive as quickly as it was said. But as quick as things have been lately, it's finally time to slow the pace down and prepare for the upcoming year.
Everybody that's not mid-distance, and mid-distance is...
You. 3 months have passed since the team has last competed. But now it's time to switch gears yet again for the upcoming season as the Jaguars have their first time trial of the year. Some are knocking the dust off and getting the wheels turning again, while others are looking to make a name for themselves as newcomers. Regardless, the entire team has nationals marked on the agenda, especially after not being ranked at all on the national team poll, despite a 24th place finish last year at NCAAs.
That was when I think everybody realized there was a disconnect there.
Yeah.
But this year is very much like, okay, we know we belong at nationals, and the goal is not just to get there, but to get the job done once we do get there.
It's the start of another season for the Jags, and just like any other race, they're off to a fast start as always. Even with a few key members sitting out, the teams managed to hold their own against a bundle of Division 1 and 2 teams in Spartanburg, South Carolina.
A lot better than we did last year. I want to say we had 5 girls at like 20 flat or faster, and we only had 1 do that last year. For the guys, we only had 2 guys get under 26 last year. We had, I don't even know today, I think it was 6, and we had 2 or 3 guys that should be top 8 sitting. So we are a lot better than last year. It's definitely a step in the right direction.
A step in the right direction indeed for the team. Of course, it's only the first of many, but for now, they'll cool down and enjoy the win for the day.
Loving having her. She's been great. Hey, boys. 28 minutes of 40 seconds at 3K to 5K effort, 80 seconds off.
Huh? Hmm? The whole 24 minutes is 40 seconds on, 80 seconds off?
Hmm?
Okay.
It's 12 reps.
I'm trying to remember. 12 of 40 on, 80 off.
Yeah.
Okay.
20 on, 80 off. 12 reps, 40.
When he said that, I was like, I know. I was expecting him to just be like, all right,
2 miles tempo. No.
Yeah.
No. We're going to touch some faster gears.
I'm okay with that.
It's a good time for it.
I like that.
Yeah.
I think we'll,
anytime we ever did the post race tempo, it was like y'all are out here running 6 flat pace. I'm like, what a. Well, after Virginia Tech, you were going like 5:20, but you also you did a tempo in the race.
I tempoed that.
Nationals 2.0.
I wonder how many people are not going to eat.
We gotta make it controversial because isn't the title of the clip Unranked?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So sitting here eating Chipotle unranked.
Unranked Augusta men eating Chipotle. Don't really care.
Chipotle would taste way better if we weren't ranked.
All right, so back to my first question. How did it feel racing there for the first time in Spartanburg eye opener? First time in 2 years.
It was a good season opener. Going back to, you know, somewhere that we ran 2 years ago, just to kind of see over the years how fitness has developed. Opened up about 40-ish seconds faster than 2 years ago. So a good little rust buster, something good to get the legs moving. You know, long season ahead, not looking to peak right now, so we're going to get a lot faster.
Hey,
we don't race?
Yeah. How can you stay in a hole with me?
Coming off of a race, everybody's still kind of recovering, so just getting a good bit of threshold volume in, not trying to do anything that hard. Guys have a bunch of threshold 800s, girls have a bunch of threshold 600s with a little bit of a jog, rest 75 to 90 seconds. We'll do like a fast start rep at the beginning, just simulate getting out fast, but not too much. It'll be a 400 for the girls, 600 for the guys. Since it's a little warm, I'm going to tell them to stop for water at least every four reps, option for every two.
Another week. Another opportunity for the team to work on things they've learned from the last meet in preparation for the next. Only difference is there's no meet for almost two more weeks. With most of them being fresh off of impressive season openers, it's time to rest and ease their bodies back into the swing of things before the pace picks back up again.
Yes. What's the first rep?
First rep.
It'll be okay.
That means it's not going to be the same rep, probably. Just asking that. My guess will be 600. Fast.
What's the rest coming up?
The rest is going to be 90 seconds.
Second jog. 2 minutes.
Coach Bergman. Thoughts on him?
He's awesome, man. You know, we were nervous when coaching changed, that's for sure. I always tell people I was waiting for the first text of someone to be like, oh, well, guys, I'm leaving Augusta too. I'm going somewhere else after Coach Ward told us he was leaving. But the guys held together, and we were like, all right, let's see. You know, Coach Ward spoke very highly of Coach Bergamy, and I don't think a single thing he said has gone the wrong way since. I mean, he's a great coach. He likes to have fun. He likes to see us succeed. He cares about us. He'll talk to you about anything if you need to. So he's been awesome with him being here.
All right. Good teammates.
Mm-hmm.
If you could describe them in one word, what would it be?
Gosh. I don't know if one word could do it. Because, you know, we're goofy. We've got time to be goofy. We're serious. Hope that plane's gonna mess anything up. Now they're serious. You know, when it's race day and we're on that start line, it's like complete opposite sometimes of what you'll see at practice. When they mean business, they mean business. But they also know when to let loose and cut up and just have a good time with each other. You know, we'll be messing with each other during like 90% of our easy runs. We're always finding something to egg each other on about. It's just a really good community, I think, of just guys that are willing to work but also know when it's time to work.
Fun. Something so trivial yet so important at the collegiate level. It's also something that the team surely lacks nothing of. Once again, it's time to have some in Columbia, South Carolina, where a smaller-sized unit of the pack is looking to represent against a variety of different division-level teams. This will also be the chance for the newcomers to get a few more races under their belts before the halfway point of the season. Successful day for the group in conclusion as they earn a second place overall as a team along a pair of individual outstanding performances.
With a time of 26:18, running unattached, Ani Tesfaye. Yay!
Yeah. And I cried throughout the whole thing.
Did we do that at
Blanchard?
Oh, I thought it was at.
No, it was at like every.
At the plantation.
I was at. That was that day. Yeah. But I had
twisted.
No, not
Blanchard.
I've seen
her in
there.
There comes a day in every season where an athlete's limits are tested beyond the demands of normal competition, and the substance of their character lies within their response. Today is that day as the team faces their hardest workout of the season in between meets.
We got a few different workouts going on today.
Some people are racing on Saturday, so we got them doing like a easy, what would have been a one-on-one off fart, like on the track. So 300 on, 200 off at like threshold down to a little below race pace. But then everybody else has what is so far of the season the hardest workout. For the oldest guys, it's mile, 2 mile, mile, 2 mile, mile. The miles are a little faster than race pace, but the 2 miles are pretty relaxed, like tempo pace. We had a few people have to go early because they had 8 a.m. Some wouldn't have been done in time, and everybody's had a pretty good workout so far. So that makes me feel a little better about it.
A hard workout indeed, but for those battle-tested, this is just another day in the life of what it takes to reach the top.
Oh, come on, you don't want to let go! Come on! Let's go, Brandon! Woo!
Oh, it's so good.
Dark blue.
Workout went good. I think everybody did what they were supposed to. We really just wanted to check the box, get a good workout in. Our main focus is nationals, of course, this year. So checking the box every day, getting it done. And I'm going to say it again, we the Jags, so we always get it done. Woo!
Hey man, it's snowing out here. This is crazy. I haven't seen this much snow in forever. It'd be snowing in New York, but I ain't been in New York in a minute. Last time it snowed in Georgia was a long time ago, so it's really cold out here, but hey, we enjoying it. They was doing some snowball fights. I wasn't messing with that because I wasn't trying to get hit, but oh bro, as I say I wasn't trying to get hit, I'm getting attacked right now. Avery, yeah, this crazy.
With the plan for this weekend, not really changing much from the last meet for our top six guys, so still trying to get out fairly hard, get position early, and then what we really want to work on is just working the middle part of the race. Like last time, Avery did a really good job of working miles 1 to 3 and put himself in really good position for the last 2 miles. But we had a decent amount of people that like settled in a good bit from miles 1 to 3 and then just put themselves a little ways back. And even though they picked off a ton between 3 and 5, it was like we had spotted some good runners a little too much distance early on. So just trying to close that gap early and not spot anybody at that distance.
It's the halfway point of the season. It's also the last meet to finalize a perfect race strategy before the Peach Belt Conference Championship meet, where the men seek to defend their title and the women seek to move up in the rankings from previous years. It's been a long day of traveling and prepping for the team, but after their course preview, they finally got the chance to settle in and find some form of calm before the storm tomorrow on race day.
Can you guys see
We're at Huntsville, Alabama right now, getting ready for the UAH Chargers meet tomorrow. It's a D2 showcase, so there's going to be some bigger D2 teams there, some teams that we're looking to compete against at Natty's. Yeah, today we took about a 6-7 hour trip from Augusta, rode in some vans. It was a good van ride. Got to the course, did a shakeout, you know, get some blood flow going to the legs. That was great. It was a great shakeout with the guys. Just got to run the course a little bit. And then we came here, had some delicious food. We demolished it. It was very delicious. Thank you, church, for picking it up. So now we're just kind of chilling, playing games back there. They go crazy in that game, One Night Werewolf. Probably going to shower up soon and get some good rest, and we'll be ready to go tomorrow.
One Night Werewolf, a card game as old as anyone on the team can remember, serves as the primary tradition for the team the night before a meet. It's a game so fun, anyone can have a blast playing it. Even Coda, the team dog.
So, Coda, pretty much the team dog. What's the backstory on that?
He's the skinwalker of the game.
I got Coda in January, and he just started coming to things. I didn't want to leave him. I didn't want to board him. He's certified, so I was like, you know, I think this could be really fun, and I think he could really get to know everybody and love everybody. And originally, it was to work on his people skills, but everybody started loving him, and they loved when he came. So it just kind of went from there.
From man's best friend to teammates and newly formed coaches, the team is the embodiment of friends turned family. Just ask grad assistant coach Hans Troyer.
Welcome to the show, the Jag Express takeoff. 38 minutes, the start of the rest of our lives.
My name is Hans Troyer, and I am a volunteer assistant coach for the cross country and track and field team.
All right. Hans, how does it feel coming back, pretty much, you know, you being at Nationals and also setting several different accolades over the years at AAU? How does it feel coming back to help the guys through the same thing, and the girls as well? How does it feel pretty much coming back to give that same experience to them?
Obviously I had a very, very good experience here at Augusta. National championships, different wins, just hanging out with the team. It was always just such a blast for me, and I always had the greatest time. And coming back and being able to experience it from a different point of view, being a part of it, I feel like it's, like I'm trying to, I guess, just like you said, like give them the same experience that I had, and just trying to, I guess, make it easy for them. But it's exciting because the things that that I experienced and learned, I see that they are still ongoing from, I guess, what, even if maybe if I taught them anything, they're still like moving on forward from that, which is really exciting for me, just to see that the program is still evolving, and I'm just happy to be a part of helping the program become the dynasty that it's becoming.
Okay, so you're kind of seeing yourself in a lot of ways as a somewhat older brother, pretty much, seeing how, how your brothers have pretty much
for sure
changed.
All my brothers, for sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
And in reference to that as well, how would you look at Coach Bergman as well?
Oh, man. He's like an older brother. We were on the same team years and years ago. At the time, you know, he was just the senior to my sophomore. And he was obviously great training mentality. He was fast. He knew what he was doing. He followed the rules. And so it was kind of inspiring at that time. And I remember I was one of the biggest vouchers of Coach when I heard that he had an opportunity to come to AU. And I was so excited to have him be a part of it. And I still am, obviously. but yeah, he definitely, I could see, nowadays it feels like we're we're like twins now. Definitely still, he's like the older twin, but now we're kind of like twins in that aspect.
So a lot of deja vu pretty much as far as seeing how your role has changed from athlete to coach, and then not also coach, but as a mentor as well.
Absolutely.
Okay. All right, and pretty much the last question, what is the thing that you miss most about AU as far as an athlete's perspective?
Yeah, I'd say just hanging out with the team. I mean, you have people to run with every single day. Even earlier today, we played One Night Werewolf, which is our favorite board game. And just playing three rounds of that, and we realized just how much I miss being part of the program, being part of something bigger than yourself. Because you can see it in all these guys. Like, obviously, they want what is best for the team and everything. And they all care about each other. And I think it's really cool to be a part of a team that cares about each other that much. And so I just miss being, I mean, obviously I still feel like family to them. they still welcome me as family, but I miss seeing them every day.
All right, sounds good. All right.
Hey, y'all already know the plan. Just get out hard enough to get positioned early and then stay on the gas. Don't settle in from 1 to 3. Just stay on the gas, make sure we don't lose spots there.
Right. This is him from the 8-15 guys. Break up their top five. You see one of these guys in our region? Passing. Just keep picking them off. Because if we can show dominance in the 8-15 spot, we're going to look even better with that 1-7. So let's lock in. Let's get it going. 1-7, guys, you know what you got to do.
Here we go.
Once again, it's time to block out the noise and put the past 2 weeks of training to the test. With a handful of teams in the same conference and region as the group, the team will get a taste of the next meet at conference and even region afterwards. But for now, all that matters is today.
Tag on me! Tag on me! 1, 2, 3, yes! Yes!
We need to move up.
No, I think it went good. Obviously, you know, we're in the right spot that we want to be. We had a lot of guys perform, a lot of guys PR. Came through with a second place finish. Probably we could honestly won the meet. We only lost by 3 points, so it's a really good placement to where we're at in the season, and we're just ready for conference.
It's a good day for the team as they see many PRs and a second place overall finish from the men's team. Next on the table is conference. Battle to see once again who rules the Peach Belt in cross country. This year, the team is heading to the University of North Georgia to compete in the conference championship meet. A 2-hour bus ride, followed by a course preview and end of the season awards ceremony, awaits them before the big race tomorrow. Additionally, junior Avery Janes has just been announced as the Peach Belt Runner of the Year.
He works hard. He knows what he wants, he has a goal, and he'll do whatever it takes to reach that goal. Really, running-wise, that's his whole personality most of the time. Like, that's his character. You see Avery, you think of running.
Man, Avery, oh, I love that kid. Avery's something else. He's so talented, man.
No, it's definitely a big honor, that's for sure. A lot of previous runners that have done a lot for the program have gotten this, so it's pretty cool to be a part of that and just to kind of earn it with the team. It's a cool little thing to get, but our focus is definitely the team first for sure. We got conference tomorrow morning and then regionals
at the same course, so this will be a good preview for us. So we're definitely looking forward to getting back out there for regionals and to show what we can really do as a team.
Even with all of the individual accolades, the only thing that matters is what the team gets done when the time comes.
Hopes for, you got any other expectations outside of the guys and the girls?
I mean, I want to use this as a good preview for regionals, because one thing that we were kind of talking about today looking at the course during the preview was it won't be as big of a deal for conference because it's a small field, but at regionals, you look at how quick that thing funnels down. Like, you got to see it. Imagine 180 people on that start line, and then 200 meters later, it's five wide. You're going to have to get out hard. And so we're going to get to experience that a little bit tomorrow before we go out to the regional. So that would just be a bit of a little bit better understanding of what we need to do.
Yeah. So a test trial.
Yeah.
In some way.
Exactly.
All right.
Preview, if you will.
Sounds good. Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise,
playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday, you got... This race doesn't have any business being close. So let's go out here. I want to make this embarrassing. I want to dominate this race as much as possible. But, you know, we need to take pride in every place we can get, not just in our top five. Our 6 through 15, take pride in every spot.
The direction of Marshall Leonard.
Oh, hi,
Arthur.
Let's
make a statement here.
It all comes down to this. Whether months of training have paid off will show by the end of the race. Good day to be a Jag, as the team see a bundle of season best performances and wins, including a first place finish by the men's team for the fifth consecutive year, led by Brandon Martin, who won the meet in one of the fastest times ever ran in the championship. Coach Bergamy also notched a Coach of the Year award for the second year in the row, adding to his own coaching streak. The NCAA regionals meet will be back in the same place soon. But for now, the team will enjoy the victory and each other.
Talk about the race.
The race was really good. We went out hard. Our plan was to go out as hard as possible, take out the good teams, try to... we know we were strong and fit. We've been doing a lot of aerobic training throughout the year. We believed in our fitness, so took it out hard and just... what we deserve. We worked hard for this, and this is what we wanted.
How's it feel to be a PBC champion?
Oh, it's great. I don't think I've ever had a race I've enjoyed more throughout the whole race. I had a lot of fans that came out, and I appreciate that a ton. I love hearing everybody out there, and it was a great race.
Hey. Ooh.
It's officially postseason mode as the team prepares to take seven women and men to the NCAA regionals for a shot at nationals. And what better way to get in the mood for such a big meet than with new uniforms?
What do you think about it? Does it look more centered that way or no?
I think so.
Okay. So the plan going in, because everybody's definitely a little more hyped up for this one than they were, which, good, we needed that. Then again, it's regionals. If that wasn't the case, it was probably a problem.
Yeah.
But plan, I mean, we know, you know, Wingate's the second best team in the country right now. So we know how good they are. The plan is just, that course narrows down so fast.
let's get out, let's get position early, let's get right with Wingate, just stay there.
Okay.
The plan's pretty simple, get position early, and then just be aggressive in the middle part of the race, don't settle in too much, like, don't leave people in the race late. So, and I think conference, like, one good thing that came out of conference, other than, you know, the kick in the pants that woke us up a little bit, the guys weren't feeling great that day, and because of the fact that Flagler was there and, you know, forced them to push those middle miles, they were going to get dropped.
Yeah.
That's what we've been trying to work on all year, was like, okay, you guys are really aerobically strong, go ahead and put yourself in pain in the second or third mile, be really aggressive in the middle, push through that, you guys are strong enough to hold that. And that's a really tough way to race, like staying on the gas for 5-6 straight miles, that's a tough thing to do, like you gotta have some guts.
Yeah.
And the guys that had a little bit of trouble, like at UAH, trusting themselves in the middle part, and they would end up getting to 2 miles to go, and they're like, oh, I had way too much left, but it was too late to do anything about it. Like, I spotted these guys 15 seconds, and I could make that 15 seconds up in 2 miles. Well, at conference, they just had to be in that position of, oh yeah, we gotta stay on the gas in the middle part of the race, not like just because they weren't feeling great. So they got put into that pain 2 miles in, had to stay on it, push through that. And so one thing in my head that's really good coming out of that is like, they know that they can do that now. So now we get a day where we're feeling good and we run like that, we can be dangerous.
Okay.
The NCAA Southeast Region Championships, the final step before nationals. The teams are different, but the course is the same as conference, so the group already has a feeling of what to expect throughout the race.
All right, boys, let's go get our plane tickets booked.
Let's get it, boys.
Jags on me, Jags on three! 1, 2, 3, Jags!
Successful day as the guys grab second in the region and a ticket back to nationals.
We just got second in the region, kind of a repeat of last year. Feels good being back. The course isn't, you know, the best, it's a little hilly, but we ran some pretty quick times today. I think everyone PR'd back a little bit. Getting ready to go to nationals now in Joplin, Missouri. We're excited about that, excited to kind of continue what we started last year, with last year being the first year that our group has went to nationals. So we're excited to really continue that and, you know, push past kind of the adversity of what we dealt with last year. So, you know, we lost two guys, Hans and Kai, that were, you know, our top two guys, but then we brought in Brandon and Jordan and just kind of picked up where we left off. So I got good hopes about it. I think we're all pretty excited. So, ready to go. And then, you know, second all region, so I'm pretty happy about that. It was a tough race, a lot of mind-numbing laps, and 6 laps and all. But fought through it at the end, had a good little surge the last 2 laps, and that put me in good position to finish strong. So happy about that.
Team did great.
I call it coach. Team did great. Everybody else killed it. So happy about that too.
With the race finally being finished, the Jags have exactly 2 weeks before the day of nationals in Joplin, Missouri. The hardest part is just beginning, but for now, they'll enjoy the day.
My name is Kai Bricky. I graduated in class of December 2022. Coming back here to check on the guys at their regional championship venue. Always a blast to see the Jags race. Super excited to see what they're going to do at Joplin. Happy that we got the job done today. We've got some loose screws to tighten up just before the coming weeks. Nothing new to us. It's just the same thing year after year. Super excited to see the work ethic is still there and that the program is the way we left it. So super stoked for the guys. Always a pleasure to see Avery up there charging up, and very happy to see Jordan Robertson and Brandon Martin join the team and be one of the Jags. Super, super stoked.
Congratulations on an unbelievable season, but we're not done yet. We have a lot more to accomplish. Best of luck in Missouri. Anybody want to say anything?
Me, yeah, I will. My name is Thomas. I'm a senior here. I've been here a while, but we're just super thankful to be able to, you know, represent ourselves on the national stage. You know, we really just want to show everyone what it means to be a Jag and represent Augusta University out there in Joplin.
Go Jag!
Send-off, the AD and the rest of the athletic department came out and gave us a big, huge good luck for us to leave early in the morning tomorrow to go out to Missouri. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be super fun. We're going for a top 10 spot, so that's the goal. Hopefully we can achieve that. But we know that we're super excited, super confident, because we put in a lot of work this year. We have the entire support, all of our friends and family back home, all around, and right here in Augusta University. I know we got to go through here. He's super excited to watch us. So it's going to be a good time. We're going to have a lot of fun. We're going to get a job done. So, Jack, thank you.
One last night of close remarks and celebrations with friends are in order for the team before they depart for Joplin. The next loud sound they'll hear is an alarm clock at 4 a.m. for their first flight. We could be heroes. Ooh. We could be heroes. Me and you. We could be.
On behalf of American Airlines and one more partners, we thank you for flying with us this afternoon. We hope to see you again soon. Have a good rest of your day.
Travel day. The longest day of any Nationals trip. The team have a flight from Augusta Regional Airport to Charlotte, North Carolina. They'll use a connecting flight from Charlotte to fly into Tulsa, Oklahoma, and drive about 2 hours to Joplin from there.
Just landed in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Won't be here for too long. Gotta get this rental car, but you know, wasn't a bad flight. It went by quicker than I thought it would, so that wasn't bad. Got to sit with my guys, so that was cool. But now I'm just ready to get this rental car, go to the course, see it for the first time. I'm excited to see what we're working with. Yeah, just ready to do this easy run and then get to the hotel and chill the rest of the day.
So the course was nice. We just got back from our flight like 2 hours ago, so we were a little rusty the first time going through. But second lap, felt a lot better and our legs were finally opening up. So the course is nice and hard. The grounding is really nice. And there's a lot of downhills in there, so you can always catch your breath on that. We're expecting a good race.
A good first day down in the books. After previewing the course, getting a meal, and checking into the hotel, the guys will get some much-needed rest for the next day of preparation. Day 2. After finally settling in and a full night's rest, the guys are ready to see what the day holds in store. They'll get a morning workout in, grab lunch, and wait at the hotel while their Nationals gifts and bibs are being picked up. This is only starting for us. You're giving me a good feeling. Something about you pulls me in. I get a good feeling.
You're getting underneath my skin. We're out here, so it's day 2 in the evening time. Well, Johnny Carino's getting some food, some delicious pasta. I got pizza because some pizza sounded good tonight.
But a lot of people got pasta. They brought out some good bread for us. And overall, it's been a solid day. Like, we woke up, had a little bit of breakfast, went for a run, and then we went and got lunch at Panera, and then got a few groceries at Walmart, came back and did some homework because we're student athletes and we got to do that. And then I chilled out, watched some TV, got our natties gifts, and then we went for a shakeout, showered up, and it's dinner time. So overall, it's been good. Tomorrow's going to be another outstanding day. Saturday's the big day, but we're just chilling, hanging out, enjoying the evening, and enjoying the team bond. Yeah. And my girlfriend pulled out. Okay. All right.
Barwin
twins. Alright, normal shakeout in 4 strides.
We just got done with lunch at Panera. Now we're on our way back to the hotel to chill for a few. Watch this volleyball game, get in the hot tub, and then shake out in like a little less than 3 hours, like 2.5 hours probably.
Yeah. And we got the banquet.
Yeah, banquet later at 5. So,
it's gonna be a chill day.
Chill day, yeah. Nothing crazy going on. Excited for tomorrow.
It's gonna go by quick.
Some rankings came out not too long ago.
Don't agree with them.
We don't agree with them, so hopefully after the race, we can flex a little bit.
About it.
A chill day, but still an important one. The guys spend it making final preparations for race day, supporting the volleyball team at conference, and enjoying one more night of Joplin. In less than 24 hours, they'll cross the finish line of the longest season any of them have experienced yet.
Guys know what they need to do. They've already done it. They've done it well. So I feel really confident in their ability tomorrow, and they all seem ready. We had a couple guys with sore throats today, but outside of that, everybody seems like their bodies are feeling good. They're all hyped up, ready to go, a lot more locked in than we were last year. So that's good to see.
Okay. So just another day in office.
Yeah,
just a bigger office.
Yeah, like I said, they're more locked in than we were feeling last year, but at the same time, it doesn't seem like anybody's anxious, stressed, any of that. It still seems like they're pretty calm about it all, but also locked in on what they need to do.
Cool.
Which is exactly where I want to be, somewhere in that middle where it's not too laid back, but not sitting here super stressed out, can't think about anything but the race, Bubba. We've been video bombed. We've been video bombed by the PBC Runner of the Year.
But pretty much just know what you need to do.
Yeah, they all know what they need to do. They've all done it, so. Feel really confident in their ability to do it. All we gotta do now is just go out there and lay it out there.
Joplin, Missouri, a gorgeous day for the 66th iteration of the men's NCAA Division II Cross Country Championships. Lots of supporters on hand today to watch summer racing, particularly running, as we get set to crown another national champion in Division II Cross Country.
Y'all are fit, y'all are ready. Let's just go out here and show it to everybody else.
In 2019, only got 1 finishers at Nationals that year, break 25 the entire regular season. We got 6 right here. Y'all are more than capable of running with the top 10 teams here. Y'all just gotta believe it and go out there and show it to everybody else. Alright,
let's go.
And with all seven guys charging through the finish line, the Jaguars wrap up the season as the 15th best team in the nation. Embraced by loved ones, friends, and teammates, it's a good day to be a Jag indeed. However, it's not over yet, as the school's volleyball team is currently fighting a battle of their own to win the Peach Belt Conference tournament.
Let's go, baby. Awesome.
What a block.
Hey, that was awesome.
What a block.
It is a good day to be a
Go Augusta Jag.
How would you say your first year with the team went?
I would say it definitely went a lot better than I expected. We definitely put in the work. We definitely dealt real damage at Nationals. Like, I'm just super stoked that we all collectively like worked as a team. Like, we all knew that we were working for something bigger than ourselves, and we all knew that we wanted it equally as bad. And it's definitely been crazy to be part of a phenomenal team. It's just crazy how quick the season went by. But we'll be back next season for outdoor track, and we'll definitely make some noise. So go Jags.
Nah, come on now. He said, I don't know what that meant.
It seems to be an unspoken rule that no Nationals trip can end without playing the infamous card game One Night Werewolf. After one more night of Joplin, the team head out early to start the journey home.
It's early. It's 4:45 in the morning here. It's early. Almost as bad as last year's, but it's early, it's cold. We got about an hour and a half drive, maybe a little bit less to Tulsa. So no more Nationals.
It's a long day with several flight delays and a near cancellation, but the team managed to make it back home with the story of a lifetime to tell. And what's even more, there's even more fuel to the fire for next year.
Overhead compartment, be careful as items may have moved in flight. You may now use your cell phones. American Eagle and One World Partners, thank you for flying with us today, and we hope to see you again soon.
So we're at the airport still. We were supposed to be boarding, or no, we were supposed to leave at 1:05, right? Yeah, we were supposed to leave at 1:05. It's 1:19. It's been delayed twice now, our flight, so we're not supposed to leave until like 4:30.
We board in 2 hours and 20 minutes.
So now we're just sitting here doing absolutely nothing.
Don't fly in 2 hours and 20 minutes.
If there's one thing that you could say to the guys pretty much in a few short words of the season, you know, what would it be?
I guess just that I'm proud of them. I mean, they've been locked in this entire season. They've done a good job of staying committed to the process and, you know, handling their business, doing what needs to be done on a day-to-day basis, and not losing focus at any point. So I guess just that I'm proud of their like level of commitment to the process and getting this job done.
Getting the job done. While most of the guys will be back to work again next year, fifth-year senior Carlos Rodriguez has officially ran his last race with AU as a Jag.
It's crazy.
It's over. Not happy with the way the team performed today. You know,
second highest finish. We got 15th as a team, so I'm excited how we did that. Honestly, felt like we could have done better too. I feel like myself as well. But I'm really happy to see what the team, you know, does moving forward. I feel like next year they're gonna go even crazier. You know, we jumped up 9 spots from last year. So I could even see them jump in 10 spots. And I really hope they get on the podium next year, which is top 4. So I think they got a team to do it. I mean, they're bringing back everybody. I'm the only one that's, you know, leaving from this top 7. So I'm excited for the future for them. But, you know, also sad, you know, that I'm done with. So, but no, yeah, like I said, I mean, happy the way the team performed. We didn't give up. We kept fighting. So I'm happy the way, like I said, the guys fought. And I'm ready to see what's next.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong and what's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond and that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first then the line will never be crossed, established it on our own when that line had to be drawn and that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone. Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way. Yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take will always lead you. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Highest finish in program history's 9th, and I would love to see that go down. I think these guys are more than capable of doing that. So next year, just how high can we go?
Okay. Speaking about next year, where is Nationals?
All the leaves are brown.
Oh, I'm mic'd up today.
Oh, you're mic'd up?
Yes, sir.
Come on, guys, come on.
Oh, just wait until I start dropping F-bombs.
Oh,
yeah. Hey, hey, you! Hey, you! Hey, we're losing to Emmanuel. You gotta go!
Okay, it's cold. Cold, bro.
Hey.
Oh.
They're 5A, Gainesville's 5A.
Yeah, I think that they were.
What's going on? Welcome.
Ready?
Yeah.
Alright. Support it.
Be back here. Just wasting time.
Oh, oh. It's either a funny smile or it's a...
Huh?
Hey,
they got
hear us from there.
Is Jordan with all his out of his bag, like it's just on the floor, and Patrick was like, Jordan can't find his boarding pass. And I'm like, I got it on my phone, like, so we're good.
Did he throw
all his clothes was like all on the floor? Like,
I'll tell you what, and he brings it back in. Ladies and gentlemen, you are currently watching free ping pong right now. It'd be over by now, so this is like overtime. OK? consider yourself lucky to be able to watch such a game like this.
Who's the minion and rat him out?
I think it's Andrew.
I think it's Andrew.
I think Andrew's minion. I think it's Brandon.
I could see Brandon. Because he was like,
oh, I would have done the trouble.
Yeah,
before.
It's gotta be Brandon, bro. Yeah, he's got a damn look on his face.
Can I flip your card?
No one touched Brandon's card?
Hey. I called it.
I don't know. You want to say anything, Coach?
No.
I did horrible. First race. Shout out to my mom. I got a real question now. You guys got the first glimpse of next year's team running without Carlos Rodriguez. How did it feel to be out there without, you know, Carlos in that starting lineup?
It felt good that he wasn't out there. You know, it felt right. You know, everything felt normal that he wasn't out there.
Hey, this is Viking season. Running out here with my boys, I feel like I can move a continent with my teeth. Not all of them feel the same way, bruh. I'm here with the sickest lineup, and not just the Southeast region, the whole entire national venue, bruh. We got the 10K specialist and tactician, Hans Troyer. We got rookie of the year, and just, wait, where he at?
No, this is terrible. This is
weather. It's amazing. This is something these guys have been begging to be at for a year. I'm usually used to be behind the camera, so for those who don't know, this is the face behind the camera. Today we're pretty much getting a drone shot of the course. We're getting some more established shots.
Think
I'll
fit?
Yeah.
Short
fit.
Like, yeah. It's tight, but. Oh,
dude, I can make it work. Oh, you gotta slide down a little bit. Ooh. You gotta squeeze all that panda.
You stole my food.
Let me in there.
We didn't miss it. I mean, it's almost like he wasn't there, you know? I just hope this makes his transition to another school a lot easier to know that, you know, it was a lot easier without him. Nah, wait, see, you're tanning, you all over me like, I'm Dillinger. No, I'm Seer. No, I'm Troublemaker. And we're just...
This is gonna happen on time. No, because the one time I'm Tanner and I hit that, you guys are going to be like, oh, he's Tanner.
Brandon, you're just
silence. I'm just going to flip.
Hey, yes, sir. Let's go.
I give you a ban if you catch
him right now. Let's go.
Ban if you catch him right now.
Come on, let's go.
Before you decide,
gotcha.
They have a new Chick-fil-A sandwich at Chick-fil-A.
Wait, they do.
You guys, put the car.
Oh, well, I'm going to drink it anyway.
Chug.
All right, heads is Chick-fil-A, tails is Chipotle.
Heads.
Flip a coin.
Heads. Not bad. I need
it anyways. It's my first workout in my team. It's starting to song.
Put them in some aviators.
Hey, you got it. Don't you got your aviators with you?
No. Hey, you got to put them on.
Oh my god. Do you even hear what I said with like a mile and a half to go?
No, I don't remember.
You were lying to us
like,
all the time.
Like, yeah, you were.
You lied to us.
Did they tell you that I was lying to y'all?
Like,
hey, no, at the. Hey Siri, flip a coin.
Yeah. It's heads. Yeah! Chipotle! Yeah!
Why'd you celebrate?
I said no!
Oh, I thought you said.
None of this footage.
Can I see it?
50 in the morning currently. We are waiting for our flight, which hopefully we get to board in 10 minutes because I'm ready to go.
What you laughing at?
What you want me to do?
I don't know, man. Just say hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom. I love you. Point to win it. Carlos Rodriguez with the serve. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. And it's game. Hans Troyer wins it after that immaculate comeback. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me for the 2022 Ping Pong NCAA Cross Country Runners Championship game. Thank you.